The Lord be with you.
Also with you.
Welcome to the second Sunday of Advent. Let me say one thing about the service. We are using setting 5 in the ELW, and we may, so it's a different setting. Well, I want you to recognize that. On page 6 of your bulletin, for the Advent candle lighting, it says the choir will sing once through, and the choir will not sing once through. I think we all know that song well enough that we will be able to sing it without having that. Our theme today is peace, and we will have the image of peace from Isaiah 11, Isaiah's vision of the peaceable kingdom where predators and prey live together in harmony, and we'll see what that means for us. Let's prepare our hearts for worship through the brief order of confession and forgiveness. Please rise. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who comes to wake us from sleep, who leads us into the light of grace. Let us prepare the way of the Lord by confessing our sins against God and neighbor. God of all time, we confess that we have not prepared for your benefits. We ignore our neighbors in need and fail in the labor of justice and peace. In your mercy, forgive us. Grant us wisdom to welcome your light and to seek the things that will endure until Christ comes again in glory. Amen. Comfort, O comfort, my people, says your God. In Jesus Christ, your sins are forgiven and all things are made new. Rejoice in this good news. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Share God's peace by greeting those around you.
Thank you.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace from above and for our salvation, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace of the whole world, for the well-being of the Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy house and for all who offer here their worship and praise, let us pray to the Lord. Help, save, comfort, and defend us, gracious Lord.
When everything feels hopeless, when we feel as dead as the dry bones in Ezekiel's valley, God calls us away from the workaday world. God calls us to breathe in the holy breath of peace. When we light the candle of peace, we breathe in the one who restores us. Whatever we face in life, God's spirit of peace will dwell within us. As we wait for God's time, in faith, we light the candle of peace. Our peace is in the Lord our God. Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Stir up our hearts, Lord God, to prepare the way of your only Son. By his coming, nurture our growth as people of repentance and peace. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
First lesson is from Isaiah chapter 11, 1 through 10. A shoot shall come out of the stump of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. The Spirit of the Lord shall rest on him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord. His delight shall be in the fear of the Lord. He shall not judge by what his eyes see or decide by what his ears hear, but with righteousness he shall judge the poor and decide with equity for the meek of the earth. He shall strike the earth with the rod of his mouth, and with the breath of his lips he shall kill the wicked. Righteousness shall be the belt around his waist, and faithfulness the belt around his loins. The wolf shall live with the lamb, the leopard shall lie down with the kid, the calf and the lion and the fatling together, and a little child shall lead them. The cow and the bear shall graze, their young shall lie down together, and the lion shall eat straw like the ox. The nursing child shall play over the hole of the asp, and the weaned child shall put his hand on the adder's den. They will not hurt or destroy on all my holy mountain. For the earth will be full of the knowledge of the Lord as the waters cover the sea. On that day, the root of Jesse shall stand as a signal to the peoples. The nations shall inquire of him, and his dwelling shall be glorious. The word of the Lord.
Give the king your justice, O God, and your righteousness to the king's son.
That he may rule your people righteously, and the poor with justice.
That the mountains may bring prosperity to the people, and the hills in righteousness.
Second lesson is from Romans chapter 15, verse 4 through 13. Whatever was written in former days was written for our instruction, so that by steadfastness and by the encouragement of the scriptures, we might have hope. May the God of steadfastness and encouragement grant you to live in harmony with one another, in accordance with Christ Jesus, so that together you may with one voice glorify the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. Welcome one another, therefore, just as Christ has welcomed you for the glory of God. For I tell you that Christ has become a servant of the circumcised on behalf of the truth of God, in order that he might confirm the promises given to the patriarchs, and in order that the Gentiles might glorify God for his mercy. As it is written, therefore I will confess you among the Gentiles and sing praises to your name. And again he says, rejoice, O Gentiles, with his people. And again, praise the Lord, all you Gentiles, and let all the peoples praise him. And again, Isaiah says, the root of Jesse shall come, the one who rises to rule the Gentiles. In him the Gentiles shall hope. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace in believing, so that you may abound in hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. The word of the Lord.
The Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew, the third chapter. In those days, John the Baptist appeared in the wilderness of Judea, proclaiming, repent, for the kingdom of heaven has come near. This is the one of whom the prophet Isaiah spoke when he said, The voice of one crying out in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord, make his paths straight. Now John wore clothing of camel's hair with a leather belt around his waist, and his food was locusts and wild honey. Then the people of Jerusalem and all Judea were going out to him and all the region along the Jordan. And they were baptized by him in the river Jordan, confessing their sins. But when he saw many Pharisees and Sadducees coming for baptism, he said to them, you brood of vipers, who warned you to flee from the wrath to come? Bear fruit worthy of repentance. Do not presume to say to yourselves, we have Abraham as our ancestor, for I tell you, God is able from these stones to raise up children to Abraham. Even now the axe is lying at the root of the trees. Every tree, therefore, that does not bear good fruit is cut down and thrown into the fire. I baptize you with water for repentance, but one who is more powerful than I is coming after me. I am not worthy to carry his sandals. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. His winnowing fork is in his hand, and he will clear his threshing floor and will gather his wheat into the granary. But the chaff he will burn with unquenchable fire. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise
you, Lord. You may be seated. I'd like to invite the children to come forward. Good morning. How do you like the rain?
I like it.
You like it? Yeah.
I don't like it.
It's. It's. I know we don't like to get wet, but it's nice when it's dry. We need the moisture. The plants need the moisture. Tell me, how many of you have dogs? Are they mean dogs?
No.
Well, tell me, does your dog play with the cat? Do you have a cat?
No.
Oh. Do you have a cat? But you don't have a dog. Okay. When I was a kid, we had dogs that were pretty mean dogs. But the interesting thing is, when they were in the house, and when the cats were in the house, the dogs and the cats got along just fine. They even would sleep together. But as soon as they went outside, those cats better look out. So predators, a dog would be called a predator in that case. This lion would be called a predator. And what do lions usually do with lambs? Eat them. Yeah. But here, there's a big lion and a lamb laying down together. That's an image of peace that comes from the Bible. Let me show you this picture. You might have seen pictures like this. That's a real lion with a real lamb laying down together in peace. Isn't that neat? Well, Isaiah had this vision that the day is coming when there will be no more violence in the world. Everyone and everything will be at peace. Isn't that nice? And when will that come? Well, it comes to us. We have glimpses of it, just like this picture. We have glimpses of it every once in a while. And we, as people of peace, Isaiah promised that from the root of the stump of Jesse, a branch would come, a king, and we understand who would rule in peace. And we understand that king to be Jesus. And he's with us now. and he can give us peace. Or at least we don't war with one another. Peace. God's peace. Paul calls it the peace that surpasses all understanding. And it comes through God, through Christ, to us. Okay? Today we're talking about peace. We're dreaming for this kind of peace throughout the world. No more violence. All right, let us pray. Repeat after me. Gracious God, we thank you for life. We long for your peace. Come to us now. Fill us with your peace. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You can go back to your seats. Grace and peace to you from God our Father and our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. My sermon title is Peace Be With You. Let's begin with three scenarios. One is a man who, after 20 years of marriage, his marriage was crumbling. And he was going to go on a business trip. And his agreement with his wife is that when he got home, she would be gone. And he got home from the business trip, feeling pretty well, pretty good. Opened the door, and no one was home. He saw dirty dishes in the sink, and he thought, I'm going to wash the dishes. My wife would really like that if I washed the dishes. But then it dawned on him that she's not coming back. He began to sob. He called his pastor, and for 20 minutes he sobbed over the phone. And his pastor didn't know what to do. His pastor simply said, "That's all right. Keep crying. That's normal. Crying is good for you for 20 minutes. Or another scenario. You may have heard the news report that in Syria, in that conflict, the amount of rapes committed by both sides is unprecedented in war. Isn't it funny that we have rules for war? And now, unprecedented number of rapes, people breaking the rules for war. And a third one, a woman wounded by her church. She calls the pastor and says, "Oh, pastor, this is so hard. It is so hard to forgive. It is so hard to heal." I think we all know that we live in a broken world, a world where it is hard to find peace, or when we find peace, it just seems to be such a fleeting moment where we find peace. We could almost say, welcome to the second Sunday of Advent. Or welcome to Advent in general, when our whole world is celebrating. John Buchanan wrote it this way: "It's a season of dramatic contrast between society's bright lights and Advent's quiet, poignant hymns about things like lonely exile. Contrast between our culture's mad dash to finish everything on December 24th and Advent's invitation to wait quietly for Christ's return, to wait quietly for Christ to come, to prepare our hearts quietly for Christ to enter. Well, in Isaiah 11, we have that wonderful passage that's called the peaceable kingdom. We aren't sure when this happened, whether this text is talking about when the Assyrians attacked Israel back in 8 BC, when the Assyrians, they were on a world conquest, and Israel was part of that world conquest, or when the Babylonians came and was part of the Babylonian exile. Isaiah just paints a picture of total destruction. Not a single building in all Israel is standing. The forest, if there is any trees, no trees are standing. Everything is clear cut. Everything is hopeless and bleak for the people of Israel. Nothing left for them. But then he gives something very hopeful. The peaceable kingdom. Because in that clear cutting, there's a stump left. And from it, a shoot will come. From the stump and the root of Jesse, Jesse being David's father, there will be now a new Davidic king that will rise up, who will be filled with the Spirit of God, who will not judge by what he sees, who will not judge by what he hears, but judge the poor, it says, with equity, one who will bring peace. The peaceable kingdom. Predators dwell in harmony with prey. Survival instincts are transformed. The most vulnerable, the children, are able to play with snakes. Now, if that isn't a wonderful depiction of a peaceful place. John Hicks, I've showed you these pictures before, made a series of paintings. He was so taken by this passage that he painted a painting called The Peaceable Kingdom. And he wasn't satisfied with one. He painted 40. I guess 20 wasn't enough to get it right. He painted 40, and they all look very similar. And people have earned their PhDs just studying this picture. Let me just show you one thing. Notice how all the eyes on the animals are so large. They believe, now a cynic would say, the predators have wide eyes looking for lunch, but his real intention was, even the animals are amazed that peace has come. And we see up in on the one side the gathering of people. That's William Penn, the governor of Pennsylvania, signing a peace treaty. He was a Quaker, a person of peace. He's signing a peace treaty with the Native Americans. So everything in this painting depicts peace. It's another one. It's not quite as rich in imagery. And there's the picture I showed the children. The peaceable kingdom. I don't know if it wells up a longing in you. Shalom, peace is coming. but a longing. Oh, yes, dear Lord, come, make it happen. Let's have an end to all the suffering and pain. Remember, some of you may remember Dave Garroway. He was the host of the Today Show on NBC many, many years ago. But he came from rather humble beginning, and he became extremely wealthy as a TV host. And someone asked him about his understanding of Christmas, and here is what he said. I've noticed that when people are asked what they want for Christmas, 9 times out of 10 they answer with something material. That used to be amusing to me, but it's not amusing to me anymore. I happen to be one of those people who can afford anything he wants, but I find what I really want, I cannot buy it all. I want peace of mind, peace of mind, peace of soul, the kind of peace you have when you really don't want anything. A longing. Well, Jesus comes and he says to us, peace be with you. Peace be with you. Not as the world gives, but peace, an unworldly peace. And the Apostle Paul called it the peace of God that surpasses all understanding. Just think, this peaceable kingdom. We have this sense, then, that God will not be satisfied until his peace comes, until that peaceable kingdom is built. Jesus came, and he worked for it, didn't he? He healed, he fed, he loved, he forgave to build his peaceable kingdom. Let's give a couple examples of this peaceable kingdom coming to us now, today. One is Martin Luther King Jr. Back in 1956, at the height of the bus boycott in Montgomery, Alabama, Martin Luther King Jr.'s house was firebombed, burned to the ground. And he stood there in front of a mob of his followers who wanted to go and riot and start killing everyone they thought was a white supremacist. And here's what he said. We believe in law and order. Don't get panicky. Don't do anything panicky at all. Do not get your weapons. They actually came armed. And he says, do not get your weapons. He who lives by the sword will perish by the sword. Remember, that is what God has said. We are not advocating violence. We want to love our enemies. I want you to love your enemy. Be good to them. Love them. And let them know you love them. The crowd wasn't completely convinced, but out of respect for Martin Luther King Jr., they all packed up and went home. And then King says, that night, just such a terrible feeling came over him. How could they do this to me? He writes, I began to think of the viciousness of people who would bomb my home. I could feel the anger rising when I realized that my wife and baby could have been killed. I thought about the city commissioners and all the statements they had made about me and the Negro in general. I was once more on the verge of corroding hatred. And once more I caught myself and said, you must not allow yourself to become bitter. King describes that war raging in all of us. Edward Martin put it this way: within my earthly temple, there's a crowd. There's one of us that's humble, one that's proud. There's one that's brokenhearted for his sins. There's one that is unrepentant and sits and grins. Martin Luther King Jr. showed that war. He allowed the war, the peace side, to win. We struggle. That's why John the Baptist comes to us and says, repent. That's why Martin Luther himself said, the Christian life is to be one of constant repentance, letting God's side win in us in that battle. So we long for peace within our hearts, within our homes, within our world. We long for the peace of God. And how about us? That's my second example. Jesus says, just think, Jesus worked to bring God's kingdom and this peace into our world. We try to do that, don't we? We try to do that. I'm sure you do it in your personal life. But here at church, we gather together. We provide Christmas gifts for foster children. We gather groceries as an Advent discipline for cross lines. We gather coats now for Holland School. We gather gifts for developmentally disabled adults who have no family to give them gifts. Is it enough? Well, it's just a glimmer. And why do we do it? To be workers in God's kingdom, so we can find some measure of peace in our world. We pray today, dear Lord, come, give us peace, settle the war raging in our hearts, have us come out on your side, your kingdom side, your peaceable kingdom. Amen. Thank you.
Living together in trust and hope, we confess our faith. I believe in God. As we anticipate the fullness of the presence of Christ, we join with the Church throughout the world, praying for all who are in need. Gracious and loving God, guide your Church universal with the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and might, the spirit of knowledge and reverence.
May we so follow that we welcome all people, just as Christ has welcomed us. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer. Holy and reconciling wisdom, let the earth be filled with the knowledge of God, just as the waters cover the sea.
Let your peaceful kingdom come, when the wolf shall live with the lamb, and no one will hurt or destroy in all your holy creation. Lord, in your mercy.
We pray for the nations and those in authority, for police officers and firefighters, for social workers and attorneys, that God grant them wisdom to work for peace and justice.
We seek your peace, even as we pray for 11 people who were injured in the Ohio State University campus, and those killed and injured in the warehouse fire in Oakland, California. And we pray for our military personnel serving around the world. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer. God, our healer, we remember the poor, the meek, the unwelcomed, and the sick.
We remember especially Jeannie Burnell Graves, Carolyn Callan, Ethan Carriger, Jana Everett, Michelle Farley, Mary Lou Fisher, Lou Graves, Jesse Hansen, Doug Hobein, Robin Kennedy, Vera Kimsey, Jack Myers, Chris Marquardt, Wayne Myers, Bill Payne, Jim Raisins, Pat Roper, Pat Chicaney, Rita St. Jimmy, Lucy Stowell, Paul Thompson, Bonnie Turner, Rod West, and Marietta Young. Are there any others?
We give you thanks for the faithful departed who have died in Christ.
We remember especially Grant Hayden. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Merciful God, hear the prayers of your people, those spoken aloud and those known only to you, and grant us peace through Jesus Christ, our coming Savior. Amen.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Savior of
the Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior, Jesus Christ. You comforted your people with the promise of the Redeemer, through whom you will also make all things new, in the day when he comes to judge the world in righteousness. And so, with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. All is ready. Our Lord invites us. Please come. You may be seated. The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace.
God, for whom we wait, you come to us in the broken bread and the cup we share. Make us ready always to welcome Christ into our hearts and send us forth to be your people in the world, announcing your coming among us in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
I'm going to encourage you to read your messenger. You'll hear, read all kinds of things in there, even about a Cadillac for sale. The church owns a Cadillac, by the way. David, it looks like you have an announcement.
I would like to remind everyone that the Springfield Mid-America Singers will be performing a Christmas concert at the All Saints Anglican Church in Springfield on Tuesday. There's a poster at both entrances. A lot of Christmas music and that kind of stuff. If you don't know where the All Saints Anglican Church is, it's near Sequoia Park. If you don't know where Sequoia Park is, it's kind of at the intersection of Lone Pine and Galloway. The All Saints Church is on Galloway. Brand new church.
What time?
I don't know. 7 o'clock?
When you say Tuesday, you mean this Tuesday?
Yeah.
December 6th. Go ahead.
Good morning. I wanted to invite all of you to our children's Christmas program, which will be next Sunday. The time in the bulletin says 4:30. We're actually going to change that. We're going to start at 4. We usually have the children work out the prelude and do some solos on the piano or singing, and we start that about a half an hour before, and what we found then is that sometimes people are walking in while the kids are performing, so we're going to go ahead and put that start time at 4 o'clock so then everybody can come and enjoy the kids as they're doing some solos and duets during the prelude, and then the program will start as soon as the prelude is over. So I just wanted to let all of you know we're going to change the time in the bulletin for next week as well, to please come and join us at 4 o'clock. We'd love to have all of you here. The kids have been working really hard, and as you guys know, it's always a lot of fun. So.
Thank you.
In case you've missed all the other cues, it is the Christmas season, and I wanted to let you know that next Sunday will be the deadline for bringing gifts for Crossline's Toy Store. So Terry Dunham and I will be transporting all the wonderful donations that have been made by our congregation on Monday the 12th, so if you're planning to bring something, particularly for the teens who we're serving this year, please do so, and if you'd like to sign up to be part of the crew from Messiah that will assist in the distribution on Saturday the 17th, the sign-up sheet is available in the narthex as well, just out here to the left as you exit. Thanks.
Thank you, Bruce. Receive this benediction. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen.
guided by the gospel, we welcome all to worship, make disciples, hunger for ministry, nurture youth, gather resources for growing ministries, offer healing and care to all need. Go in peace. Remember the poor. Thank you.